Hello everybody, welcome to Art Thrill Studio, and today I'm going to tell you about Madhubani leaves. Generally in Madhubani paintings we see a lot of greenery, lot of forest, trees, flowers, but we fall short of how many types of, we generally tend to repeat the same kind of leaves. So today I'll give you the variety that you can opt for depending on what you want to do. So generally we do with small leaves, big leaves, banana leaves, different types of leaves. As we generally see the plants, there are different kinds of leaves. We can make the same kind of leaves in Madhubani. The only thing is that the lines will be solid and they will be having intricate line patterns. So let's get started. So I'll draw a very simple leaf. So I'm just drawing a double line, because double line is always a highlight for the leaf. So here I'm just making a simple leaf. Anybody can do that. And we can have it in clusters, in groups of many, and then it will be even dense. Now you can, again, the highlight that is going to keep it separate from the background and it will look pretty. Now, if we want to color this leaf, we will color it with this one color and it will be called bharni. As the word says, bharni means that we have to fill, and kachni is the intricate line pattern. We can also make the patterns like this in black ink, pen, nib, whatever you're using, you can make such lines and make it kachni. You can also use green lines to make it a little bit more vibrant, but still it is not going to be throughout filled with color if you are choosing a kachni. So here this is my basic leaf. Now how to assemble this leaf in one stem? So we can go, this is my branch and I am making similar leaves. And that's how I will make the whole branch filled up with leaves. You can make it of different sizes, you can make it of slightly different shapes as they tend to bend, and adjust your picture according to the space that is there. Always remember to add the highlight, because that adds to the beauty of Madhubani. This is the basic trait of Madhubani. The lines, they are very important. So this is the kind of the branch system that we have made. Now you can extend yourself and do the kachni or bharni. If in case you want to do bharni, you will fill the whole leaf with one color. If you want to do kachni, you will do it with the lines. You can choose a black pen, or you can do the same thing with the color pen or ink. Now the different pattern for the leaf is few long leaves. So generally when we make bigger plants like neem or anything, how would we do that? We are making smaller leaves, but yet I want to keep it separate from the background. So I will make both the sides, I'll make smaller leaves, and we can, because it's very difficult for us to make double lines for very small leaves and we don't want to put in a bigger ones. So how we are going to do it? So I'm filling my whole leaf style like this. And now the second outline that will differentiate it from the background will be the outline. But here I'm doing the background like this. So there are many small leaves, but yet they are bound to be in one stick. So this makes our simple leaf look a little bigger formation and it looks better. So you can do multiple like this, coming from the tree or growing from the ground to fill up your place. Now, how to do the bushes? There is one more thing, how to do bushes. We will make the grass grow like this. Here, we can do different patterns. This is a simple pattern of the grass. Generally, we make the ground like this. So, keep it attached to the end. And here, now again, we are going to do the highlight and do it with double lines. So this is my grass that's growing, and here I will be filling it with simple kachni lines, which are going just one side sideways. To differentiate with the angles, you can make the other one in a different angle, and there, so it stands out and doesn't mix at all. So wherever you have places and you feel that your picture is looking vacant and it is the scene where grass is there, plants are there, you can actually go ahead and fill up whatever the place requires, shorter, smaller, bigger, whatever way you can fill up your place. Now, there is one more leaf that we generally use in the kalash or anything, that is the banana leaf. So we will just go with like this. Now I am making a second line a little broader again for the highlight. This is very important. See that you form a curve. It is big and it is long. It's going downwards. So this is one end. This is the end and this is the source. This is the beginning of it and this is the end. Now from here we will take some thickness and we will make broken lines. But these broken lines are going till the end here. Now, since our banana leaf is very, very broad and tends to split from the middle, so it will look like this. So this is my banana leaf. And if you observe banana leaf, it will have lines. So again, kachni looks beautiful in this. And you have to go straight lines going down to give your plant and leaf beautiful effect. Generally, you will see that any picture that we are making, gods, Ganesha, the plantains or the banana leaves, will look very beautiful among the small ones. I generally tend to make few of them in my pictures. Later you can color it with whatever color you want, green, dark green, light green, whichever shade you want to do it. But I'm just giving you a rough sketch and the options that you can go ahead with to draw your picture. So these are the leaves. The same way, but this is just one leaf. How are you going to incorporate it into a plant? So then again, the formation will go like from the same source going like this. Again, the thick main rib of the leaf, and then again the broken lines, and then tend to just end it going downwards because that is how the leaf is. I'm just showing you the other one, how it splits, and it's really easy to make and very beautiful. So you can just color it or do the kachni in this also. It'll look equally beautiful. So these are very simple ones that we can do. Now here with the bushes, if we have to go for the bushes, what will we do? We can go on with small leaves. Now here I'm making few leaves here. Again the outlines. always remember, do the second outline as well, because if you color, only that part will highlight it and it'll look very, very pretty. So this is how we are going to do our next, maybe bush or whatever you want to do it, or a branch from the tree, anything. So you can just put these without the main branch, you can just do the bushes. So when you are making a tree, the branch, you can show the branch as well. And if you are not doing the tree, it's just the bushes, it's the grass or some plant, you can just do it like this. Few other details would look pretty, like some flowers growing in with it. Simple, very simple, tiny flowers, they add to the beauty. Again, we will do the double outline and save our flower like this, highlight it, and it will look very pretty. Now, depending on your choice, again, your line pattern can be your choice. Here I am just doing single line pattern of Kachni here, and then leaving one side, I will color Bharni on one side and leave it the same way. Now, one more pattern that looks very, very pretty is, this is one leaf. You can have different variations. You can have different variations in the same pattern of leaf. They all look very beautiful. So here again, the second outline, and now I'm giving it a little fringy effect. So fringy effect, I want to do it like this, and this is a new formation of a leaf. So there's no set pattern that you are supposed to do it like this. Be creative. Think what you want, how the space, what will complement your picture, and you can start drawing on your own. The only thing is, remember your light lines and your patterns. They should complement, and they should prove that it is a Madhubani drawing and not a doodling. So here again, I'm filling it up like this. Lines and patterns play a very, very vital role in your Madhubani, depending whether you want it single line, or here I'm putting a checker effect. So I'm just putting some checks in here. It's just a variation. Whatever you want to do, you can do it. Though in leaves, generally we do single lines to show the ribs of it, veins of it. Now generally, if you color it up, and it will brighten the leaf pattern. So these are basic leaves, different kinds of leaves that you can do. There is one more, which is a coconut plant. What will happen if you want to make a coconut plant? So the coconut plant is coming down here again, just like I'm doing this one. Now coconut plant will be like very, the tooth of this leaf will be too deep, and it's growing, it's going like this. This is how my coconut leaf is. I can make coconut leaf, I can make banana leaf, I can make bushes, I can make different kinds of plants. Again, the same kind of lines will flow in, and it will give you a different kind of effect. So if you want to make a scenery which has a village scene, or which is not a very close up picture, it is open and it gives a variety of plants in the site, brings them inside, then you so this is the way that I have done the coconut tree. This is my plantains or the banana leaves. These are kind of crotons or simply adorned beautiful leaves with extra details. These are the bushes, the ones which do not have the main branch system. They are the bushes or the grass. Here we can have the leaves from the trees. So these are the basic leaves that you can put in one picture and make your picture look beautiful. Now the next video will be on flowers. What type of flowers can you put in? So please stay connected and join me in my next video. Thanks for watching.